to create a 3D print using our UPS printers, we're going to use the UP icon located on a shortcut on your desktop. The blue box with the UP. Really pretty simple interface. We're going to go File, Open. You're going to find your STL file. Mine is on a USB drive, so I'm going to find that in my little dialog box here. Go to my USB and pick the STL file that you want to print. Once you have your design in the UPS printer interface, you can left click and drag to change the view. And if you right click, it will move up and down, left and right. Couple important things to set up your print. We can rotate our object, which might be important depending on where we want our support structures and how we want our support structures to be built. You can hit place. This will center the design on the build plate, and it will also, more importantly, place your object on the build plate so that it's not hovering in midair. When you do hit place, you will recognize that you can see a little bit of space between your design and the build plate. That is where the raft is going to go. So it's okay if there's a little bit of space under your design and the build plate. Another important thing when you are using the move, rotate, and scale tools, if I were to scale this and I wanted to scale it down halfway, I need to set how far I want to scale it, and then I have to hit the scale button one more time for that action to actually occur. And so now our design is half the size, and we'll notice that it's now floating in midair. We need to make sure we place it down onto the build plate. I'm going to lay my design flat on the build plate surface this way because it will use way less support material. And we'll talk more about support material later and how to set your part so that it is most effectively printed. Alright, so once you're ready to print, you're going to go 3D print. You're going to initialize your printer. Once the printer has been initialized, you'll be able to click the 3D print button, and you'll have to be a little patient, wait for the printer to beep at you, and then you can do Control P or File Print. Couple important options you need to make sure that you are aware of. First one being the quality. This will dictate how fast the printer head is moving. We usually keep that on normal. If you have more of a fine print, it will take longer, but you can do quality fine as well. And if you really need to get something out fast, it will affect the quality of your print, but you can run that at fast. Heat platform after finished. We do not want our platform heated after it's done, unless I know absolutely that I'm going to be there when the print is finished, but I don't want to take any risk and have that printer heating the platform all day. You can select no raft. 99% of the time you do want a raft on your print that holds the part down onto the build plate. There's a real interesting pause function. If you do want to change the color or the filament type in the middle of the print, you need to set that ahead of time. You cannot pause it manually during the print. preferences, this is where you get into more advanced understanding of the printing process. Our Z resolution, we're going to set at 0.20 millimeters. That is as high as quality as our UP minis can print at. The part angle, this is the angle that the printer head moves. The surface of your part, generally set that to 2 layers. The thicker the surface, the more layers you're going to have on the outer surface of your part. The infill will dictate how hollow or how filled in the part is. The top left option is going to take more material. Your part will be more filled in and it will take the print time a little bit longer. The opposite goes for the bottom right selection. You'll have less infill, faster print, and use less material. When we get down to support, this is dictating the support material, the scaffolding structure that can hold up overhangs. You can dictate at what angle the overhangs will be built using this drop-down menu here. There is a real good diagram with a green bowl form indicating your part, and the red indicating where the support material will be built. How dense, that's how thick the support material will be. The space determines how many spaces are in between the support material, and the area indicates how far over the overhang, how far an object needs to be sticking out in order for support material to be built. If you do not want any support material, you're going to click the area and only base. That will override all of these other options you have here, and there will only be a raft at the base of your object. And that's what I'm going to select with this design that I have here, because I do not have very many overhangs, and the overhangs I have are very small. When you have all your options selected, you're going to hit OK. You're going to hit OK again, and it's going to convert your object into layers. It will send those layers to the printer. You do need to make sure that you have material, enough material on the spool. If you believe you have enough, you're going to click no, because you do not need to add any more. You just have a good amount of material on there. It's going to send those layers down here at the bottom left. You'll see that your computer is sending the layers to the printer. Once the printer has received that information, it's going to store that G code within the printer. It's going to tell you how much material the object is going to take up, the estimated print time, which is fairly accurate, and when that print will be finished. You will click OK, and it's important that the printer is always talking to you. It may not start printing right away because, as you see in the bottom right of your screen, the nozzle and the platform need to be heated up before the print begins. So if you click that print OK, and it does not print automatically, your printer is warming up. Don't think that it has forgotten about you. At this point, it's really important that you keep a close eye on your print. The first 2-3 layers are extremely important in ensuring a successful print, so do not walk away from your printer. Make sure you get those first 2 or 3 layers down and you're confident that the print will be successful before you take your eye off the machine. If you need to stop your print at any time, there's the big stop sign in the top, and you can click that and it will cancel your print automatically. Happy print.